Lord Asriel.
Master, gentlemen, I'll get straight to the point.
As some of you are aware, this photogram was taken at the magnetic North Pole in Svalbard, Kingdom of the Ice Bears.
Lord Asriel, is that light rising up from the man's body or coming
down? No, that's coming down from the sky, but that's not light.
It's dust.
How on earth shall you provide the energy?
I shall break the unbreakable.
I will not have my niece slithering round like an alley cat.
You're not very grateful, are you?
I almost wish that I could have told Lyra that these were her last days at Jordan College and that her time with Roger was coming to an end. She could have said her goodbyes and perhaps prepared more for her coming journeys. But then how could she have prepared? How could she have prepared for the new relationships in her life and the new responsibilities she would gain?
What's this?
An alethiometer. It tells the truth. It is of the utmost importance. Mrs. Coulter does not know that you have it. Do you understand me? Utmost importance.
Lara's new world was one of wealth and comfort, and of the motherly affection she had so long yearned for. How was a young girl to resist? Lara was thankful for all that Mrs. Coulter had given her, but soon learned that these gifts came with a steep price. Mrs. Coulter demanded obedience, submission, from even those closest to her. Lyra saw the darkness beneath the engaging exterior and did not like it.
Billy and Roger!
Lyra?
Lyra no longer felt safe with Mrs. Coulter and quickly made up her mind to leave, taking only her most prized possession. Mrs. Coulter was not inclined to let go of any possession, especially so valuable a treasure as this little girl. Lyra was pursued and would have been caught. But help arrived from an unlikely source.
Egyptians.
Her new friends would not only protect her from the long arm of Mrs. Coulter, but welcome her as family.
Marcosta.
And so it was, during her meeting with John Farr and Father Corum, that Lyra first attempted to read the alethiometer.
The Master of Jordan gave me this.
It's an alethiometer. You've got three hands you can control. By pointing at three symbols, you can ask any sort of question you can imagine. Once you've got your question framed, this other needle points to more symbols that give you the answer.
Can I try?
What are you doing, Lyra? You don't know how to read it.
Hush, Pan.
A difficult task at best. A fool's errand without decades of practice and a host of manuals. Lyra performed the impossible without a moment's doubt. It was this night that Lyra and I first met. She was certainly pleased.
Who are you?
But I could live another 1,000 years and never forget that moment.
Father Corum wishes to know whether child cutters take their prey.
Warwick Bernison, may I speak to you? We want to offer you employment.
I am employed by the townspeople.
What kind of work is that for a Panzerbjorn?
Warwick Bernison, why are you wasting your time here?
I stay because the people of this town gave me spirits. Then they took my armor away. War is the sea I swim in. Without my armor, I am nothing. A bear's armor is his soul, as your demon is your soul.
It must have been terrible to lose your armor.
It was no less than I deserved. I fought another bear in single combat and was defeated.
Oleg!
Too hasty. Boy, I see it. There's no need for a dust-up. Say, you fellas just calling a day. Howdy, Yorick. Figuring on joining this turkey shoot?
Yes. I have a contract with the child.
That's some pretty fast work, Miss Lyra.
With Lyra's help, Yorick Bernison regained his armor and was ready to leave Trollsund. The bear agreed to join the adventurers and assumed the role of Lyra's protector. Quickly, the two formed a bond that ran far deeper than simple oaths or promises.
Samoyed lands.
The Egyptians and their new companions continued north, unaware of the horrors lurking so close by.
What is it, child?
In the next valley, there's a lake with a house by it. And it's troubled by a ghost. And Roger, you could take me there, couldn't you?
Yorick and Lyra's efforts had reunited at least one family with a lost child.
Why did they do that? It hurts.
Their joy, however, was short-lived. With a battle raging around them, Lyra thought nothing of her own safety and bade Yorick go to the aid of their friends. The Egyptian camp was safe, but Lyra had not been so lucky. They say that every cloud has a silver lining, and indeed, as terrifying as it was to be stolen away from her friends, Lyra now found herself at the very place she had travelled so far to find. Reaching her goal was only half the journey, however.
You'd better come inside. It's warm and comfortable.
There was still work to be done.
Why would it
be off with you?
I'm very interested in discovering how several children managed to wander free from the station.
Mrs. Coulter, I hope you'll understand that the question is moot.
We have already recovered two of the three missing children. I think...
Lyra! 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 Ah, there we go!
Don't!
No, 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 no.
Don't
no,
you
no.
touch!
No one is going to hurt you. No one is ever, ever going to hurt you.
They did it to Billy and those other kids. They cut their demons away.
I'm going to tell you something, Lyra. Something very important. Something you didn't know.
Lara, is this it? Are the Egyptians here?
Come on!
The children escaped from one danger, but were not yet entirely out of harm's way. After all the terrible things they had endured, after all the time away from their families, alone and scared, the children were finally safe.
A good one. Better get a hold of something.
I'll search for a break in the storm.
Lyra!
As Lyra would find time and again, the end of one journey always leads to the beginning of another. And what appears to be an unfortunate ending may in fact be the start of a beneficial turn of events. By this time, word had spread among the bears. As the two warriors prepared for the fight, it was clear that Ragnar and Yorick were more than two bears. They were two kinds of leaders, representing two futures. Two destinies. Finally, through tooth and claw, the true king at last reclaimed his throne and further strengthened the bond he shared with Lyra. Her reunion with her father proved less satisfying, however.
No! Get back! I didn't send for you! Anyone but you!
No, I came to help you.
Lord Asriel's reaction to Lyra's arrival was puzzling. He was visibly upset.
Lyra.
I came to give you the alethiometer and rescue you from the bears.
Of course you did. Thorold, draw a bath for these two. Prepare them some food.
Yes, my lord.
It's all right, Roger. We're safe now.
Come along, young sir.
I want to thank you, Lyra, for bringing me exactly what I needed. Sleep well, daughter. Sleep well.
That night, Lyra was plagued by thoughts of her father. When she woke to her dear friend Roger missing, she feared the worst. After learning the horrible truth of her father's plan,
Roger?
Lyra and Yorick set off, hoping to reach Lord Asriel
Yay!
In time.
Yay!
Lyra and Yorick pushed on, close to their final goal. They both knew what had to be done. There are no words that can convey the powerful bond of friendship and love between Lyra and Yorick. But it was Lara's journey now to continue on for both of them. She thanked him for all he had done, turned away from the world they knew, and walked into the sky.